CloudBerry Backup is an ultimate backup solution available for Linux, Mac, and Windows. It supports almost all popular cloud storage and, of course, local storage. With CloudBerry Backup, you can create many backup plans in one program. Each plan can have its own source, destination, schedule, and backup retention policies. CloudBerry Backup also supports block-level backup, so only the differences between the source and destination will be backed up. Moreover, CloudBerry Backup is able to compress and encrypt your data during backup. It is available as freeware for personal use, as well as premium personal and server editions if you want advanced features such as compression and encryption. Let's have a look at CloudBerry Backup in more details. When you download CloudBerry Backup, you can use it for free for personal use, but with a limit backup size of 200 GB and without encryption and compression. You can try encryption and compression for 15 days as a trial, and if you like them, you can get any of these licenses with a 50% discount by following the link in the description. CloudBerry sponsored this video and kindly provided this discount for my subscribers. CloudBerry Backup for Linux comes in DAB and RPM packages, which you can easily install through the software center of your distribution. I will show you only the graphical program, which is aimed for desktop use, but there is also a command line interface if you want to run CloudBerry Backup on a server. To create a backup plan in CloudBerry Backup, you need to click on Backup. Since this is a fresh install, there are no storage locations added yet. If you click on this plus icon, you will see quite many cloud options to make backups. Amazon S3, Google Cloud, Oracle Cloud, and many more. You can also select file system to backup to a local storage such as a USB hard drive. Local storage is pretty intuitive to configure, so I will show you how to use Cloud Backup with Google Cloud as an example. Let's name this storage as Google Cloud Storage. Select authentication with access and secret keys. You can also use other authentication methods. To get the keys, go to the Google Cloud website. If you don't have a Google Cloud account, you can apply for 12 months free account. You will get $300 credit for free for 12 months. Google claims there won't be any auto charge after a trial ends. When your Google Cloud account is created, you also need to create a bucket for backups. Next, you go to the settings of your storage. Here, go to interoperability and create a new key. These are the credentials you will need to give CloudBerry Backup access to your Google Cloud project. Copy and paste your access and secret keys. Click on Bucket and select a backup bucket. Now you can create a backup plan. Let's name this backup plan as Google Backup Plan. I will enable block-level backup. Block-level backup allows you to backup only modified parts of the files instead of running a full backup every time a file is changed. So this way you will save your bandwidth and reduce the backup time. Then you select what you want to backup. I will backup only the most important files to Google Cloud, which are located mostly in my Documents folder. I select it. I will backup all files, but you can also add some filters here. I use a free version in this video, but if you get a CloudBerry license, you can also enable compression of your data, which will save your bandwidth and storage. A license would also allow you to encrypt your data before it is backed up. By default, CloudBerry Backup keeps free versions of your backed up files. You can change these default settings here, and you can also decide how to handle files that have been deleted locally. For example, you can delete files from Google Cloud 30 days after they were deleted from your computer. Here, you can schedule your backups. I usually backup my files daily at midnight. I also very like the feature to run a backup if a scheduled time was missed. With this option, CloudBerry Backup will backup your files next time you boot your computer. We have set the schedule for block level backup. This way only the differences between new and old files will be backed up. But to make your backup plan safe, CloudBerry also recommends making a full backup from time to time. This is when you backup all your files completely, not only the differences. I do full backups monthly. Next, you can also enable email notification of executed backup plans. I usually enable notifications only when a backup fails. Check the summary of your backup plan. If everything is correct, you can save it by clicking on Done. I will also run this plan right now to test it. If I click on this plan, I can see some summary information. The schedule we have just created, source and destination of this backup plan, and what is most important, when it was executed and whether the backup was successful or not. My last backup was executed successfully. Let's go to Google Cloud and check the files that have been backed up. You need to go to Storage, your backup bucket. This is the CloudBerry Backup folder. You can see that CloudBerry Backup also saves the hierarchy of my directory. And here is my Documents folder with all the files backed up successfully. Now, let's test an option to restore the backup. I will delete this test file and try to restore it. To restore the backup, I need to right-click on my Google Cloud backup plan and select Restore. I do not need to run restore on schedule, so I select Run once. If you want to restore from a specific point in time, you can choose the point here. I have just done this backup, so I will restore the latest version. Here I select to restore the deleted file. You can of course restore a full folder. Also, if you want, you can restore your backup to another location than the original location, which is also a nice feature. I will use the original location. If you used encryption, you need to provide your encryption password. Keep in mind, I use a free version here, and I am able to decrypt my data. So restore with CloudBerry Backup is always free. Even if you encrypted your data with a paid version of CloudBerry Backup and lost your license, you will be able to restore your backup. Your data is always accessible to you. Here again, you can enable email notification. Let's test this email notification. Check the summary of this restore action and click Done. I have received an email notification. The restore plan ran successfully. And if I check my Documents folder, I can see the deleted test file has appeared here. CloudBerry Backup works pretty well. It is a nice backup solution. The interface of the program is very intuitive. Basically, you can access everything from this left panel. For example, I use Google Cloud to backup my most important files daily. I also use an external USB drive to backup all other files in my home directory weekly. And I also backup my system files monthly. You can also find here your storage location. And check the history of your backups by plans or even by files. The program is pretty intuitive to use, so I'm not going to show you all its features. I just want to add that CloudBerry Backup has all possible options to handle symlinks. This is a pretty unique feature of CloudBerry Backup. To make sure you retain all your data and do not forget to backup symlinked files, you can backup original files instead of symlinks. Or even backup original files in their original location, when CloudBerry Backup encounters a symbolic link. You can also set the download and upload speed, and you can even enable remote access to CloudBerry Backup through the web interface. Just make sure the port indicated here is open in your firewall settings. Here you can activate your license, and let me remind you, if you decide to get a CloudBerry Backup license, you can get a 50% discount by following the link in the description.